current radar technology transmits and receives energy in the horizontal direction. And so all you're really getting is a one-dimensional picture of whatever's really out there. So NOAA's National Weather Service forecasters can say there's precipitation there, it's heavy, but they have very little to no information on what type of precipitation it is. Dual polarization technology, in addition to that horizontal direction, adds a vertical direction, giving you a two-dimensional picture of what's out there. And so they're able to identify the type of precipitation, how heavy it's falling, track its movement, and then provide a much more accurate picture in their products and more confidence for the American people. One of the most important things that meteorologists would want to look at would be debris that a tornado churns up as it's rolling through, say, forest or whatever it hits. And so that debris has a distinct signature because it's not precipitation. Forecasters can detect that. And then in a warning or a follow-up statement, say, confirmed tornado by this radar, even when a human on the ground can't see it because it's nighttime or maybe rainfall is obscuring it. For the most part, before dual polarization technology, you'd have to have either a report of damage after the fact or have a human spotter on the ground that's physically looking at the storm and you know, calls up the weather service and says, hey, there's a tornado here. At night, and if the tornado is obscured by rain, that's pretty much impossible. Dual polarization technology allows, in the absence of a human spotter on the ground, detection of the tornado. And so forecasters can then get that word out to the public, get that out to the media, to emergency management that, hey, we've confirmed a tornado in this area. To the general public and NOAA's partners, that's a much stronger message, which in essence would elicit a much stronger response to take cover now because a tornado has been confirmed.